Department of Education, we've got constitutional mandate to ensure that the children who are the national asset of this country are supported educationally. So I want us to remove even the thinking that says we are here, I'm going to defend this individual or this taxi operator. Our responsibility is to ensure that the child is the one that benefits.
The funds should be available to ensure that learners are eating every day that they are supposed to be at school. So the short message is this. You know the difference between surplus funds and savings. Surplus funds is what you can use to buy additional equipment now. Savings must be treated carefully. Learners must eat until the last day of this financial year.
I'm from Zimajani Primary School in Ruadevar. I've got 260 learners. 40 learners are transported by the bus. My challenge here is when the bus is not available, we have learners who are not coming to school. Sometimes the buses have to take learners from Roka High School to some other places. So sometimes learners will never come to school. And the other challenge here is learners who are from Bergman, Kailisha, they are traveling crossing the NA route.
Transported learners, a very reliable person, had no problems, very good communication between us. If we got extra classes, he waited for the learners. He in now, before lockdown. At the moment, it's Mr. Maloki. He indicated to us that he's only going to transport learners until the end of the month, but we have got no indication what's going to happen. The learners is asking. I hope that I get the answer today, because we've got enough space in the hostel, but it's private, it's not a hostel project at the moment.
The experiences that you had at the farm at the beginning of this year, ever since January, I think that I'm not sure of the dates, but it's somewhere in February, I'm sure the 7th of February, learners were not being transported. And then we had a challenge. Only at the end of, almost at the end of the term, the nurse started to be transported.
One of the things that we have agreed to, firstly, is that learner transport now is in the Department of Education. We must do it differently. The first thing that we have agreed at head office is that Madam, who was doing NSNP, brilliant work, she must also do learner transport. At the district level, the people who were doing NSNP, I don't know who they are in the two districts, né? But probably they are here. They continue with learner transport. We are going to re-engineer learner transport. And that is why we are bringing in hostels, to say that like, all these people are working with you. They must come together. They are here seated amongst us now, to come and listen. What are the challenges that we have in the learner transport field?